going on, everybody? It's Popular Stranger, and we are back at you again today with another Mutt17 player card review. Today, we're going over the brand new team of the week, DeMarco Murray. This is a limited time card, so it was only in packs for 48 hours. 93 overall with the bruising back and chain mover chemistries. Let's go ahead and take a look at his stats. We'll have some gameplay coming up on the video in a couple minutes here, so stay tuned for that. 90 speed, 89 agility, 87 ball carrier vision, 86 juke move, 90 truck. He has 91 because of chemistry boost right now for me, but the normal card has 90 trucking. 91 carry, 92 acceleration, 86 elusiveness, and he is 6 foot. So let's go ahead and scroll through the rest of the stats. Guys, if you got any other cards that you'd like me to review, feel free to leave them in the comment section. We just finished up a review on the brand new Randy Moss card, so if you missed that one, go check it out. Thanks for watching this part of the video. Let's go ahead and jump into the gameplay. As always, let's go ahead and start by talking about the pricing on this card. On the Xbox One, you can find them for about $304K, and on the PlayStation 4, about $290K. These averages for this card and any other card can be found on Mutthead.com. They also rate him as a 96 overall power running back, 90 elusive back, 93 receiving back, and a 96 overall goal line running back. Now, unfortunately, this card is not on MuttRank.com just yet, so we can't compare him to other running backs. But I've played with quite a few so far this season, and I'm going to come out and say it right away. For the coin that this card costs, it is absolutely not worth it at all. It's not a bad card, but we're talking 300K for a running back. There are far better options. If you're specifically looking for a power back, I think one of the most popular cards in the community right now is the most feared Derrick Henry, and it's certainly deserving of that population, or that popularity, I should say. It's a very, very good card, and when I used it over the last couple weeks, I found that it could do the same exact things that this DeMarco Murray card could do. So nothing really separated this 300K card from something that's going to cost you around 50 to 75K. So again, if you're looking for a power back, go get most feared Derrick Henry, or you can even get the flashback DeMarco Murray. I used that card in Draft Champions quite a few times, and it was very, very impressive. Again, this one didn't do those same type of things, or anything above that, I should say. It did do the same type of things that the flashback card did. Not a big play back. I wasn't able to really break for tons of big plays. Now, I don't know if that's just me and my running style. I'm not the greatest runner. My go-to stuff is passing the football, but I wasn't really able to break down the field for big, huge plays like I was able to do with my team of the week, LeSean McCoy. So that was kind of a downfall for me. He does fall forward a lot, though. Upon contact, he usually falls forward, or he gets some type of animation that's going to break at least one tackle. Usually when he's gang tackled, though, he will go ahead and fall forward. Doesn't fumble too much. Maybe a couple times when I tried to truck somebody, I got popped right back. It was usually by like a Brian Dawkins, a Brian Urlacher, or Cam Chancellor. So it was somebody who had really good ability. There weren't any gold cards that were knocking him off his feet. Very, very good in the passing game. I didn't really expect him to, but he caught a lot of footballs in traffic, out in the flats. Very dependable there. But again, just not worth the coin. If you got the coin, go ahead and try it out, but I don't think it's worth it. Thanks for watching, guys. Peace.